The legislature changed it so that now Amazon would have to pay sales tax to the state for anybody that, if they had any presence in the state, meaning affiliates, they would now be liable for sales tax. So they kind of said, screw you, no North Carolina affiliates, basically. But, you know, most of us probably have a phone with some sort of video camera on it. And if you have an iPhone, I mean, you could literally on an iPhone, you could record yourself and in 5 minutes have it published to the web without having to edit it or anything. And so, I mean, if you think about what that used to take just 5 years ago to be able to do something like that, it's pretty amazing where we're at. So the key thing, and this is the big thing that differentiates the internet from offline traditional marketing, most people don't track their offline marketing well. You guys understand the difference between, and when I say a keyword, because that's really one of the key things that we got to know. So keywords, anything you're going to type into Google. And it may be, it's not necessarily one word, it may be a keyword phrase. So it might be how to lose weight, right? That's a keyword phrase that somebody's going to be bidding on, things like that. This is a pretty common problem, right? You spend $2,000, $3,000, $4,000, whatever, or you build a website yourself, whatever, and you're all excited, you spent 2 or 3 months building it, and you make it live, and nothing happens. It's like, if I build it, they'll come, right? No. Some sort of call to action on the website that invites them to either request a free report, download a white paper, sign up for a webinar, download a coupon, download a trial of software, anything, but have them take some action. There's a million places that you can get links to your website offsite. And you can either do it yourself or you can pay people to do it. There's lots of different ways to do it. That's why it's important and should be one of your primary objectives. And while I say it should be one of your primary objectives, I don't necessarily feel it should be your number one objective. The reason for that, which we'll talk about in a minute, is there may be certain keyword phrases that can drive a lot of traffic to your website that don't generate a lot of business.